Hey everybody. Whoa, what was that? This is interesting. I'm looking at my screen here where I can see myself on my iPhone, and it's like this lime green color. I don't know. If you see that same thing, I apologize. I have no idea what we're doing here as far as that, unless it's a Cinco de Mayo thing that I didn't know about. Anyway, welcome to One Take Tuesday. We're gonna have some fun, aren't we? Whoa, unless I kick over all my stuff that I go over in front of me here. I thought I had this all worked out ahead of time. I worked on it. All right, we're gonna start out with a song that I wrote. She sat looking out the window, flight 802 leaving London. She knew when she arrived, he'd be waiting to talk to her alone. As she sat there on the tarmac, flight 802 going to Boston. I know it's green, I don't know what to do about it. She knew when she arrived, he'd tell her that he was leaving home. Why can't love last forever? Why can't the feeling stay strong? Why do people hurt each other? When it's over, we carry on, carry on. Nothing lasts forever, he told her right before she left Boston. She just told herself he was talking about her music career. But a voice deep down inside her told her that there was a need to worry. It gnawed at her heart till it became her greatest fear. Why can't love last forever? Why can't the feeling stay strong? Why do people hurt each other? When it's over, we carry on, carry on. Hey! As she sat there on the tarmac, flight 802 leaving London, she decided right then and there she never would arrive. So she got back off the plane, flight 802 going to Boston. She headed out for France aboard an outbound train. Why can't love last forever? Why can't the feeling stay strong? Why do people hurt each other? When it's over, we carry on, she said. Why did we hurt each other? Why couldn't the feeling stay strong? But now that it's over, this'll make one hell of a song. I'll write a song and carry on. Just joined us, welcome. I have no idea why we're green. It's not easy though. It's not easy being green. I promised my kids I'd never do that again, and I just did. So, anyway, welcome to One Take Tuesday. If you were here last night for the mic night with my good friend Rick Barr, we were happy to raise some funds for the staff at Stad's Pizza. Where is it? It's right there. In Blacklick, Ohio. because Rick is Rick, Alex, Alex Sadler. They've had to cut back to just carry out, as many restaurants have. So anyway, I want to do a song. They're all songs, people. But one of my favorite songwriters, a guy by the name of Tom Petty. For some reason, this song always reminds me of my dad, because my dad grew up in southern Illinois, a little town called Harrisburg, and met my mom during the war. And my mom was from Columbus, Ohio, so my dad had to learn how to talk more like a Yankee. There's a southern accent where I come from. Youngins call it country. The Yankees call it dumb. Got my own way of talking, but everything gets done with a southern accent where I come from. Now that drunk tank in Atlanta is just a motel room to me. Think I might go work Orlando if them orange groves don't freeze. Got my own way of working, but everything is run with a southern accent where I come from. For just a minute there, I was dreaming. For just a minute, it was oh so real. For just a minute, she was standing there with me. There's a dream that I keep having, where my mama comes to me and she kneels down over by the window and says a prayer for me. Got my own way of praying and everyone's begun with a southern got my own way of living, but everything gets done with a southern accent where I come from. Tom Petty for you. Appreciate y'all showing up. If you got here late, I don't know why everything's green, but it's not easy. There, did the same joke. If you were here earlier, live with it. So happy Cinco de Mayo. I'm going to play all my Cinco de Mayo songs for you right now. There you go. You're welcome. Somebody requested a song earlier today by some guy who apparently he was named after a restaurant where you can get everything you want to eat. I don't know if I'm going to do that Jimmy Buffet song or not. We'll see what happens. Okay, I got a little bit of bourbon here, if I have a little bit of that, and it might help me out and get me to say, eh, okay, I'll do that. But thanks for showing up for One Take Tuesday. I'm always excited to do this here thing for you. I'm going to do a thing. I saw Shirley Yule showed up. Hi, Shirley. I was going to do these a little bit later, but I've got the hankering for doing a couple songs for Bill Huell, a good buddy of mine who passed away a little over a year ago. And he would always come in and ask me to do this song whenever he and Shirley came out to a gig. So this is for Bill and for Shirley. Mother's eyes. Oh, Loretta, when you look at me, it's so surprising to hear you leaving me behind. When I think of all my love for you, I can't keep from crying. Oh, Loretta, did you just think of this today? Oh, Loretta, are you serious or are you playing with my frail emotions? Knowing how I feel for you, do you really care about what you're about to do? Oh, Loretta, remembering years gone by. Oh, Loretta, how I held you when you cried and how I tried to share your happiness. I reached out in your pain. Will you walk out, turn your back on me, and break my heart again? Take off and start running. You know your mother and me love you so much, we won't try to make you stay. Time has come to be on the run, and we won't stand in your way. Oh, Loretta, got your mother's eyes. Oh, Loretta, when you look at me, it's so surprising to hear you're leaving me behind. When I think of all my love for you, I can't keep from crying. Whoa, Loretta. Whoa, Loretta. Oh, Loretta. Oh, Loretta. Love you too, Shirley. Thanks. Well, I wrote that song when my oldest daughter graduated from high school and came and informed me that she was moving out of the house. And actually, I wrote the song several years later, but I was thinking about that day. And when I wrote it, I of course, her name is Nicole, because if you got a teenage daughter and you're a songwriter and you want to live, you don't put their name in a song. So she's now 40 years old, and she and her other two sisters, who are both adults now, now say, "That's my song." No, that's my song. So it's for all my daughters who have now turned into wonderful, beautiful, very confident women. So this next song kind of goes along with that, because I learned this song was written in 1920 or 1922, and I heard it on an old Jerry Jeff Walker album. And and at the time I heard it, it was back in the mid-70s. And I just thought, eh, that's a very nice song. But then when my brother passed away in 2001, my best friend and mentor, my brother Steve, I heard that song a few weeks after his funeral, and all of a sudden it hit me exactly what that song, what the meaning of this song is. It's going to be on the new album, and I've had the honor of playing it for since those days when my brother passed. I've had other buddies who have passed, and they all fit the category of this song. One, of course, is Bill Huell, and another is my good friend John Davis, who both have passed away in the last year and a half. And so I want to do this song for my brother and for John and for Bill, and it's called My Buddy. Not so long since you went away, I think of you all through the lonely days. Buddy, oh buddy, your buddy's missing you. I miss your voice, miss the touch of your hand. I miss the way your eyes saw things upon the land. Buddy, oh buddy, your buddy's missing you. They tell me life's a book to study, lessons to find. Oz was written, we'd part, you and I. Buddies through the good days and pals of things fall. It's just these gray days I miss you most of all. Buddy, oh buddy, your buddy's missing you. Yes, sir, they say, it must be in God's plan. I'll be like a good boy and say I understand. But buddy, oh buddy, your buddy's got the blues. Buddy, oh buddy, your buddy's missing you. Hope you enjoyed that one. Since I'm talking about my brother, I want to do this song for you. It's a song I wrote it. Oh wow, I probably wrote it less than a month after my brother passed away. He was a priest in the Catholic Diocese of Columbus, a much beloved priest, and he and I, we were on the same wavelength. Politically, religiously, and everything else. A lot of my concern for social justice came from my brother Steve. And about a week before, well, it wasn't even a week. It was very close to when he was chosen to go across the bridge to the other side. He was laying in his hospital bed, and my sister-in-law asked him if he would give us a blessing, and so you could tell a lot of it came from his heart, but some of it was pharmaceutically induced, but it was really bringing out where his heart and his mind were getting ready to go to the other side. And thinking back on that, and his choice of words for that blessing brought this song to me. So I call it Stephen's Song, and it's going to be on the new album as well. Steve loved folk music, country rock music, and especially bluegrass music. So this is going to end up being kind of a bluegrass song when ends up on the album. It's called Stephen's Song. I know I'm running down the road a little faster than I should be going. I should be taking my time to see the beauty that's all around me. How could I know just where my life would go? There were no signs in front of me. Just around the bend, another dead end or a new road for me to see. Taking life for granted, it's a habit that most folks share. Live our lives to the fullest, enjoy the sun, the rain, the wind in our hair. How could I know just where my life would go? There were no signs in front of me. Just around the bend, another dead end or a new road for me to see. I've taken a lesson from my brother. Enjoy life and all there is to see. It's a greater good to share with each other. Before he died, he shared this with me. How could I know where my life would go? There were no signs in front of me. Just around the bend, another dead end or a new road for me to see. How could I know just where my life would go? There were no signs in front of me. Just around the bend, there is no dead end, but a new life waiting for me. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. Was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. Thanks for humoring me on that. Steve and I had a special bond with the song Amazing Grace. Back in the early 70s, Judy Collins came out with a Wales and Nightingales album. And I was just a kid hanging out in the front yard of our house there in Clinton Township in Columbus, Ohio. And Steve came home. He had just gotten back from Schottenstein's record department there on the north end of Columbus. And he grabbed me by the arm and said, "Come here, you got to hear this." And he had just bought the Judy Collins album. We went in on a little portable stereo record player that he had. And that was the first cut he played for me. And it was just an amazing thing to hear that song. And I have a hard time listening to it now. But what are you going to do? All right, I'm going to do another song for you. You know, that's all they are, folks. They're one song to the other. If you are seeing me in green, it's not just because I'm more than half Irish. It's because there's either something weird with my iPhone or there's something on Facebook that's weird. Because when I set everything up, it was all this beautiful color. Well, except for this part right here. The rest of it was all beautiful color photo and or picture. And then as soon as I hit play, it all turned green. So I guess that's our part of, that's the whole part of the Cinco de Mayo is that we have a green screen. So there you go. John Prine song that's always been one of was always one of my dad's favorite songs. I always used to sing it for my daughters, who were my little pumpkins. You must be daddy's little pumpkin, I can tell by the way you roll. Daddy's little pumpkin, I can tell by the way you roll. It's 11:15 and you're sleeping on the bedroom floor. I can see a fire burning, burning right behind your eyes. See a fire burning, burning right behind your eyes. You must have swallowed a candle or some other kind of surprise. Well, I'm going out to Newark with $300 in cash. Going out to Newark with $300 in cash. All the women in Newark gonna see how long my money can last. I'm a-going downtown, gonna rattle somebody's cage. Yeah, I'm going downtown, gonna rattle somebody's cage. I'm gonna pick on a guitar and strut all around the stage after quarantine. Well, if you see my baby coming, don't you tell her that her daddy's in jail. See my baby coming, don't you tell her that her daddy's in jail. She'd sell a little pumpkin to raise her sweet daddy's bail. You must be daddy's little pumpkin, I can tell by the way you roll. Daddy's little pumpkin, I can tell by the way you roll. You'll never do nothing to save your doggone soul. Pick it again. Thank you, John Prine, for that beautiful song. Fun song. I don't know if it might not fall into the beautiful category, but the fun song, which that's cool too. So, talking about my dad, I'll do this song for you. That's on my, if you're new to this here page or you're new to my music or whatever, I have 8 albums out that are all available somewhere online. And if you go to davehawkins.com, which is my main page, they're on the interweb or whatever they call that thing that's on the little box that you look at pictures with little typewriter keys on it. Can you tell? I got to call my 6-year-old grandson if I want to know anything about computers. But yeah, my webpage is davehawkins.com, where you can find pretty much all my music. And it's also available like on Spotify and iTunes and stuff like that. I have no idea how that stuff works. Thank God I have people who help me out who are a lot smarter than I am. Carl Yaffe and Sue Spiker, two of my internet mainstays. So, but anyway, this is on the album that came out in 2017 called As Long As We Get There. And it's a story about my dad growing up as a kid in southern Illinois, a little town called Harrisburg, Illinois, in Saline County. And when he was about 10 or 12, he joined the Future Farmers of America. He decided he was going to raise himself some chickens, enter them in the Saline County Fair, and he just knew he was going to win a blue ribbon. 2 weeks before the Saline County Fair, he came home from school and somebody had stolen all his chickens. So as he was telling me the story, I was writing this all down to write a song about it. Wrote a song while I was on the road. When he passed away while I was on the road. So he never got to hear the song face to face. But I know he's up there now listening to it. So this is called Somebody Stole the Chickens. There you go. Melvin was raising some chickens as a project for the FFA. He'd clean out the chicken coop and feed them before going to school every day. He knew he had some winners and looked forward to the county fair. But one day when he came home from school, the chickens just weren't there. Somebody stole the chickens. Rhode Island Reds, it might have been a neighbor. Some jealous kids Melbourne's chickens ever made it to the Saline County Fair. They probably ended up in a chicken pot pie on someone's dinner table somewhere. Now Melvin's daddy told him, it's your own damn fault. This probably never would have happened if the chicken coop got locked. In the middle of the Depression, folks will do anything for their next meal, even if that means stooping down to beg, borrow, or steal somebody's stolen chickens. Rhode Island rents, it might have been a neighbor, some jealous kids. Melvin's chickens never made it to the Saline County Fair. They probably ended up in a chicken pot pie on someone's dinner table somewhere. Chicken picking. Melvin approached his 90th year and I visited him one day. He told me the story about chickens, how he had the urge to pray for all the folks who got nothing, and we should help them when we're able. And he hoped whoever stole chickens are grateful. Let's gather round their table. Somebody stole chickens. Rhode Island rents, it might have been a neighbor or some jealous kids. Melvin's chickens never made it to the Saline County Fair. They probably ended up in a chicken pot pie on someone's dinner table somewhere. That one's for Dad. Thank you all for showing up. I'm not quitting or anything right now. I just wanted to thank you all for showing up. And if you were at the big Mike Night thing that my good friend Rick Barr hosted, I just had a brain fart. I'm sorry. It was for the staff at Stats Pizza, because you know, they're struggling keeping open with carry out food and everything else. The best, one of the top like 10 or 20 pizza places in the United States, these United States of America. And if you go in and ask for the Dave Hawkins special, you can get an Italian, yeah, it's an Italian sub, double meat, double cheese, and don't tell the wife, but man, whenever I can sneak out and get there, that's what I get. No banana peppers. I'm a wimp when it comes to that kind of stuff. So that's how, the NBP, no banana pepper sandwich. If Alex is there, just tell him I want the Dave Hawkins special. He'll know what you're getting. Don't tell the wife that I get those all the time. So, trying to get my girlish figure back, but. I'm gonna do another song for you. It's gonna be on the new album. I'm tweaking things here and there as I'm playing. Okay. Sorry, I got my mom's teeth in. I'm the youngest of four boys, and growing up, we had all our little secret or special language we would say to each other. There was one thing that if somebody was asking you for a favor, you'd say HYS, which just meant help yourself. But one thing my older brothers were always talking about, Steve and my oldest brother, Mickey, was someone who, like, it could be like this beautiful movie star or some lady you would see in the store. Or, well, yeah, because we were guys, so we were looking at the ladies, I guess. I was too young to know what that meant. But anyway, they could be the most beautiful person in the world in looks, but they were real jerks. And so my brothers would always say, yeah, you know, beauty's skin deep, but ugly goes clean to the bone. And that song stuck in my head when I was thinking about a relationship I was in a few years back. So I wrote this song. I wrote this song just about a year or so ago because I was thinking of back in those days. So it's going to be on the new album as well. It's called Long Time Coming, Long Time Gone. I don't know just where the time goes. Don't know if I care anymore. Go down the road just doing what I'm doing. When trouble comes, learn to try to let it go. This feeling's been a long time coming. If I paid attention, I would have seen it all along. Look in my rear view mirror. See, it's been a long time gone. You knew for sure I was meant for you. I knew you were meant for someone else. If we had seen the way everything was going, I never would have gone through that hell. Feeling's been a long time coming. If I paid attention, I would have seen it all along. Look in my rear view mirror. See, it's been a long time gone. Years are gone, but something kept me waiting. Together, we always seemed alone. I never could see past the beauty there before me. Yeah, beauty's skin deep, but ugly's clean to the bone. Feeling's been a long time coming. If I paid attention, would have seen it all along. Look in my rear view mirror. See, it's been a long time gone. Looking in my rear view mirror. I see it's been a long time gone. There you go. Speaking of alcohol, I don't know. Hey, Chris. Hope you and Janine are doing well. Oh, man. Now you got me thinking about opening day and I'm going to cry. I'm gonna do two songs for you that are the most requested songs I think these days in my live shows, and they're both off the newest album that came out in 2017. This first song was inspired by my wife, but it's not about my wife. I always have to preface this song by explaining that. And speaking of which, I now have to have a bourbon. If you're just recently joining us, in honor of Cinco de Mayo, apparently, Facebook decided to turn my screen green. I have no idea what the heck's going on, so. But anyway, this is a song inspired by my wife, but not about my wife. And it's just because she kind of gave me the first line of the song, and the song kind of wrote itself after that. And it goes just like this. You're thinking I'm drinking way more than I do. I don't think I drink quite enough to put up with the likes of you. It's another round of bourbon just to get me through the night. You curse at me and I curse at you. Nothing I do is right. I'm married to a bottle. Keeps me sane, or so it seems. It's a marriage of convenience. Just me and old Jim Beam. Well, you smiled and you told me I was your man. Then you turn around and you act like you don't give a damn. Well, maybe your baby shouldn't be your man. I should turn around, just walk away. Maybe, darling, that's your plan. I'm married to a bottle. Keeps me sane, or so it seems. It's a marriage of convenience. Just me and old Jim Bay. Things to end this way. I thought we'd be together for the rest of our days. Now my heart's about as empty as this bottle I hold. I guess I'll be all alone till the day I grow old. 'Cause I'm married to a bottle. Keeps me sane, or so it seems. It's a marriage of convenience. Just me and old Jim Beam. Me and old Jim. It's a love song. So that song and this song kind of share spots as number one and two, and it goes back and forth depending on where I'm playing, I guess. Young woman was getting grief from her teenage daughters about her choice of clothing when they were going to the mall. Surprisingly enough, her husband came to her defense. This is what ended up happening. She said, I used to catch every eye every single time that I walked by. People said I was a toast of the town. Now a few kids and a few years later, I don't think of myself such a hot tater. I could tell from what she said she was feeling down. And I said, ooh, baby, what you mean to me? Keep loving and hugging you till eternity. Let's know what I say and what I mean. I still pick you up in a New York minute. chase your love, do anything to win it. I think you look so hot, even in mom jeans. Even in mom jeans. I'm walking down the aisle at a Kroger store. Gonna pick up some canned goods and it's out the door. Gen X moms in tight jeans and low cut tees. Every aisle they're smiling, how to do? I think you need a break, what'll I do? In the clear aisle I'll find a beauty man just for me. And I say, ooh, baby, what you mean to me? Keep loving and hugging you till eternity. Let's know what I say and what I mean. I still pick you up in the New York minute. Chase your love, do anything to win it. I think you look so hot, even in mom jeans. Even in mom jeans. Beauty's in the eye of the beholder. Don't matter if you're younger or you're older. I looked her in the eye and I told her, some straight from the heart and straight from me. Hey! Honey, you know you still catch my eye every single time that you walk by. Darling, it's something I just can't deny. We've raised our kids, it's a lot of years later. To be a honey, you're one hot tater. Ain't no reason to be feeling old so down. I keep saying, ooh, baby, what you mean to me? Keep loving and hugging you till eternity. Let's know what I say and what I mean. I still pick you up in a New York minute. Chase your love, do anything to win it. I think you look so hot, even in mom jeans. Even in mom jeans. How about some black jeans? Or white jeans? Chartreuse jeans? Or even striped jeans? How I love them mom jeans. Oh yeah. How I love them mom jeans. Mom jeans. I wrote that song with the entire intention of just sending it down to my publisher in Nashville to shop it, to get it out to some of the big stars to see if it would end up on an album somewhere. And I demoed it, and I was doing a playback to make sure it sounded okay before I sent it out, and my wife burst into the studio and said, "You have to put that on an album." So put it on the album, as long as we get there. And so I made her pose on one of the pictures on the album cover. There you go. Can't really tell it's her because it's from behind. She and a friend of hers, they're standing there with their mom jeans on because it was too expensive to actually pay models to come and do that. So, but anyway, getting back to the new album that I'm working on. It was supposed to be out by this fall, but that I don't think that's going to happen, folks, because one of my band members is down in Nashville. Two or three of the other band members are down in Cincinnati. I'm here in Central Ohio, in Newark, Ohio, is where I live now when I'm not on the road or working down in Nashville or on the road. So we're kind of sending tracks back and forth over the interweb. I send them to my six-year-old grandson who figures out how to where they're supposed to go. But anyway, for fun, it's been about 6 or 7 years ago, I did this song online. I was doing this little online concert. It was like a half hour thing. And I just threw this into the mix. And ever since then, people keep asking me if I will do this song. And I haven't done it ever since because I had to get the real feel for it. This is the first time I've done this since that time that I've done it live for anybody. So you all get to hear the very first live version of this. And if you've come to any of my workshops at folk festivals and stuff where I talk about presenting songs or presenting yourself on stage, I always say, never apologize before you do a song. That said, I'm sorry if I screw this up. It's written by Trent Reznor of Nine Inch Nails. And I actually picked this off of a Johnny Cash Americana Sessions album, and I'm going to do it for you now. I hurt myself today to see if I still feel. I focus on the pain, the only thing that's real. The needle tears a hole, the old familiar sting. Try to kill it all away, but I remember everything. What have I become? My sweetest friend. Everyone I know goes away in the wear this crown of thorns upon my liar's chair, full of broken thoughts I cannot repair. Beneath the stains of time, the feeling disappears. You are someone else, I am still right here. What have I become? My sweetest friend. Everyone I know goes away in the end. You could have it all. Find a way. Hurt. Hope you all like that one. Not a happy song, but got a few more songs for you. I'm going to send you on your merry way. This next song, I want to do a song that for me it was a very high compliment. I was playing a club in Chicago not long after the Manchester Mornings album came out. So that would have been about 2005, 2006. And I got up and I played this song, and then I went on break. I had played my set and I played this song and I went on break, and a young man came to me and said, I really liked that last song you played. And I said, oh, well, thank you. He said, what John Prine album is that on? And I said, well, actually, I wrote that song. He says, really? Because it sounds like a John Prine song. And so, you know, my just wow. You know, somebody mistook one of my songs for a John Prine song. One of my biggest, my number one songwriter hero. So I'm going to do this for you, and then I'll do a Prine song for you. Drop of water in the ocean, drop of oil in the stream, drop an interest in a love life for you and me. Drop in temperature but rising, Somehow it ain't surprising. The spark's still in there somewhere for you and me. Burning ember of love, it's hot and rising. The fire burns so brightly for you and me. Ember becomes a flame. Who are we to cry and complain? If our love lasts forever, we'll let it be. It's hot and rising. Fire burns so brightly for you and me. Ember becomes a flame. Who are we to cry and complain? If our love lasts forever, we'll let it be. Ember becomes a flame. Who are we to cry and complain? If our love lasts forever, we'll let it be. Let it be. Let it be. All right, two more songs for you. Saw Chris O'Brien on there. Chris and his wife Janine, good friends of mine, from WGRR FM down in Cincinnati, Ohio. Every year, that major holiday that happens in spring, we're all aware of that major holiday. You know, it's of course, opening day. And I always go down on opening day morning, play a baseball song that I wrote several years ago, which last year, it was the 100th anniversary of the opening day parade in Cincinnati, which the city shuts down for the opening day parade because the Reds are the oldest professional team in baseball, professional baseball. And it was their 150th season, and it was the 100th anniversary of the parade, and I was actually asked to rewrite my song especially for that. If you go to davehawkins.com, I believe the video of us making the song is there. My band members are in there playing with me, and a bunch of my friends, Mike Tacolvi, who was the chief engineer, and we had a really good time. And it became like the official song last year for the holiday. But anyway, I would always go in on the morning of opening day and visit with Chris and Janine on their morning show, Married with Microphones. And this year, obviously, we didn't get to do it because there hasn't even been a baseball season this year. So what I'm going to do is the next time I play, I'm going to pull out my baseball songs because I'm really missing baseball. I get on YouTube and just watch old baseball bloopers and whatever I can, a few innings of whatever team I can, even though the Reds are my favorite team. But I just want to let you know that if Chris, if you're still on, let Janine know that I'm going to be doing that. I just want to do a couple baseball songs. But I promise you guys I'm going to do two more songs and then get out of your hair. So this is a John Prine song that was on my Best That I Can album. And it goes just like this. I'm an old woman named after my mother. Old man is another child thrown on. Dreams were lightning, thunder was desire. Old house would have burnt down a long time ago. Make me an angel that flies from Montgomery. Make me a poster of an old rodeo. Just give me one thing I can hold on to believe in this living is just a hard way to go. When I was a young girl, I had me a cowboy. He weren't much to look at, just a free rambling man. But that was a long time, no matter how I tried. Years just flew by like a broken down dam. Make me an angel that flies from Montgomery. Make me a poster of an old rodeo. Just give me one thing I can hold on to believe in this living is just a hard way to go. I can hear them there buzzing. I ain't done nothing since I woke up today. How the hell can a person go to work in the morning, come home in the evening, have nothing to say? Make me an angel that flies from Montgomery. Make me a poster of an old rodeo. Just give me one thing I can hold on to believe in this living is just a hard way to go. To believe in this living is just a hard way to go. John Prine for that wonderful song. I'm gonna finish out. Make sure you check out the website DaveHawkins.com. On there, there are buttons where you can get to, I believe, the Facebook page, the songwriter Facebook page. And there's also a thing that'll take you to my YouTube channel. A lot of older stuff there. Not too old. I mean, you know, I'm just a kid. This is a title set again. Got my mom's teeth in. If you join late and you're wondering why it's green, if your screen is green, I have no idea. I was just thinking it's either Cinco de Mayo, maybe Facebook's doing that. Maybe it's just because the Irish half plus of me is leaking into the screen or something. But anyway, it's green and it's not easy. I know, that's the third time I've tried that joke. Anyway, hi all, Kermit D. Frog here. So I'm going to finish out with a title cut of the album that came out in 2011 called Best That I Can. And I hope you enjoy it. Here it is. It goes just like this, or almost like this. If I knew what I was doing, it would go just like this. And it's out of tune. There we go. I tune because I love. You were 12 years old when you thought that your daddy didn't love you. 17, he caught you with your boyfriend in the back of a Ford. At 19, you ran off and you joined the circus. At 21, you told everybody that you found the Lord. Are you looking for a boyfriend? Do you want a real man? I'm right here, baby. I can do the best that I can. You never said you didn't love me. You never told me you did. Are you looking for a full-grown man or a grown-up kid? There was a porn shop across the highway from a mobile station. Way too much information, I couldn't take anymore. The retired two-bit whore got out of a station wagon. Crying, it just ain't no good men around here anymore. Are you looking for a boyfriend? You want a real man? Well, I'm right here, baby. I can do the best that I can. You never said you didn't love me. You never told me you did. Are you looking for a full-grown man or a grown-up kid? Here we go. Boyfriend, do you want a real man? I'm right here, baby. I can do the best that I can. You never said you didn't love me. You never told me you did. Are you looking for a full-grown man or a grown-up kid? You were sitting at the end of the bar with scotch and soda, humming John Denver tunes underneath the old breath. All us old men nursing our beers couldn't help but notice. We were thinking that dying in bed with you would be a hell of a death. Are you looking for a boyfriend? Or do you want a real man? I'm right here, baby. I can do the best that I can. You never said you didn't love me. You never told me you did. Are you looking for a full-grown man or a grown-up kid? Tell me, are you looking for a full-grown man or a grown-up kid? There you go. Whew, I haven't done that song in a while. Thank you all so much for showing up. Sorry about the green screen. I won't say the stupid joke, because it's not easy. Check this out. This is going to go to tape, so you can still see it online, and it's also going to go over to the YouTube channel. Go to DaveHawkins.com and it'll tell you where to get to all that stuff. You can also sign up for an e-newsletter. Susan's out, my social media lady. She went somewhere to help her daughter who has young children, but her daughter's an essential worker. So Susan's watching grandkids so her daughter can go help the rest of us who aren't essential, apparently. But anyway, check out there. And every Tuesday at 7 p.m. Eastern time, I'm back here with One Take Tuesday. And every once in a while, I'm going to be popping up here and there. I forget what. Oh, I'm calling them the guinea pig session, where I might have some song that I'm just trying out, or I've just written a new song and I want you guys to hear it and see what you think of it before I put any more work into it. But again, thank you all so much for showing up tonight. I try to keep it around 60 to 75 minutes, and I think I did that tonight. So like me on Facebook, and if you want to keep track of when I'm going to be showing up, I guess there's some little button you can push that'll tell you when I'm showing up. So thank you for that. Thanks to everybody who has shown up tonight. Thank you to everybody who's supporting everybody else. There are a lot of us who this is our primary income, and some people have been throwing some money into my PayPal account, and I thank you all so much for that. What else did I want to thank you for? Oh, and I'm still kind of mourning the fact that I saw Bill Cohen's on here, a good friend of mine from over in Columbus, former star on FM radio, NPR, newsman, and one of the most trustworthy news people ever, in my personal opinion. And a fantastic folk singer as well. And when I saw his name here, I just remembered last weekend was supposed to be the 24th annual Central Ohio Folk Festival, which obviously was canceled. So next year will be the 24th annual. Well, it'll be the 24th Central Ohio Folk Festival. This year, I guess we had to take a breather thanks to COVID. But anyway, Bill, thanks for showing up. So support your musicians, support your small restaurants and places where you can go out and get carry out. They need you. I know they need you. Tomorrow I'm going to be stopping by Stad's Pizza, to get my, Dave Hawkins special, sub. And I think that's it. Again, take care of yourselves. Thank you, essential workers. I just saw, Jason just came on. He is married to my goddaughter out in Pahrumph in Nevada. She is an essential worker. She is a nurse working at a hospital, putting her life on the line for everybody that needs someone to save their lives, which is why, for me, it's important to stay home. And if I have to go out, I wear a mask and I stay, what, it was 60 feet away from everybody? I can't remember what it is. Usually people try to stay 60 feet away from me. But anyway, thank you to all the essential workers. I can't name everybody by name because I'd be here forever. But Kat Barber, I am so proud of her and her husband Jason and their kids. She's my goddaughter. He is my godson-in-law. And all four of my kids are essential workers. They're either working warehouse work, My one daughter is a guard at the prison hospital in Columbus. My other daughter works at the hospital as a counselor. And also I have a son-in-law who's working in the prison system as well with my daughter. So thank you all so much for keeping us safe and keeping things moving forward until we get past this horrible virus. So this is Dave, DaveHawkins.com. Check it out. Like the page. Sign up for the e-newsletter, which comes out every month or two. And I will see you either in a guinea pig pop-up session or next Tuesday, if not before. Okay? Love you guys. Love each other. Love the earth. Take care of yourselves. Stay healthy. And I will see you next time. Dave, peace out.